Will you tell us what makes you think that the Exocomps are alive?
Sir, when the Exocomp left the access tunnel prior to the explosion, it may have been attempting to save itself from destruction.
Do you have any basis for that conclusion?
Yes. When you attempted to override the Exocomp and send it back into the tunnel, it responded by deliberately burning out its control interface.
Deliberately?
The computer diagnostic showed that the Exocomp disabled its own interface.
That could have been nothing more than a malfunction.
However, 2 hours later, when it was back aboard the Enterprise and no longer in danger, it repaired itself. I believe the Exocomp was protecting itself. And if that is true, it has demonstrated an awareness of its environment and an ability to adapt to that environment.
You're anthropomorphizing these units. Like any mechanical devices, they occasionally malfunction. One time I saw an Exocomp enter a reaction chamber for no apparent reason and vaporize itself. Is that supposed to make me think it was depressed and suicidal?
Doctor, why is it so difficult for you to accept the fact that the Exocomp could be alive? After all, you're talking to a living machine right now.
And I have nothing but the utmost respect and admiration for Dr. Soong's accomplishment. But his intention was to create an artificial life form. I created the Exocomps to be tools. And there is a big difference between data and a tool.
Doctor, there is a big difference between you and a virus. But both are alive.
If the possibility exists, no matter how slight, that these Exocomps are life forms, then we must examine that possibility.
Thank you, sir. And until we have a definitive answer, I believe it would be inappropriate to exploit the Exocomps as laborers.
Captain, that's absurd.
If they are intelligent life forms, we have no right to force them to work for us.
That's like me telling you not to use your tricorder.
Tricorders aren't alive.
Neither are Exocomps.
Clearly, these are difficult issues to resolve. We have to proceed very carefully. So the first task is to test Mr. Data's hypothesis.
Data, you're claiming that this Exocomp may be alive because it demonstrated survival instincts, right?
Yes.
Then why don't we just threaten its survival again and see what happens?
Make it so.
Doctor, we're pretty much ready here. You can begin programming it. What we've done, Captain, is to recreate a situation similar to the one the Exocomp encountered in the plasma conduit.
We've created a small conduit breach in this tube. The Exocomp would normally take several minutes to complete a repair of this type. Once it enters the tube, it will find that a plasma cascade failure is in progress.
Assume this is a simulation.
Oh, yes, sir. We're running a transient overload signal that will simulate a failure in exactly 1 minute.
If it does possess a survival instinct, as Mr. Data claims, it will exit the tube before the minute is up in order to save itself.
Very well. Proceed.
Okay. Beginning test program now. 1 minute. Seconds. 30 seconds. Exploded with the Exocomp inside. Go ahead, Doctor, bring it back in.
Well, Captain, I think we've spent more than enough time answering this question. I hope the outcome wasn't too much of a disappointment for you, Mr. Data. It certainly came as no surprise to me.
Thank you for your help, Doctor.
You're welcome.
Well, I consider this time well spent.
As do I, sir. Thank you.